Here I am once more, David Ginn, with my friend Avalon, who has suddenly gotten very tall, and that's mainly because she's standing on a 9-inch stool. Anyway, Avalon, I have a handkerchief right here. I'm going to take it out. I want you to reach in here and pull the bag inside out. Grab the bottom and pull it just like that, so I'll know that there's nothing in there until we put the handkerchief in there. We'll do that in just a minute. Let me put this aside because I brought along a couple of my handkerchiefs. These look like my Cub Scout handkerchiefs, yellow and blue, and I'm going to tie them in a knot, a K-N-O-T, just so, and I'll put them right here so you know where they are. Now that you know where that is, we'll get back to that in a minute, but I want to tell you that I brought along my rabbit, Harry the Magic Rabbit, except he's not real. He's a puppet. You know what I mean by a puppet? The real Harry is lazy. He's at home asleep, but I have him down in this house. This is what I call his rabbit house. So you see, I'm going to get him to come out. Harry, can you come out of there? Come on, Harry, don't be shy. Boys and girls, when I count three, shout, come out, Harry. He will. One, two, three.
Come out, Harry.
And here he comes, Harry the rabbit. He's looking around at all the boys and girls. He's looking at Avalon. Oh, yes, what? She looks like a rabbit. She does not look like a rabbit. She looks like a little girl in the third grade. Now, you quit being silly. This is my rabbit puppet, Rabbit Harry. You know why I call him Harry? It's not about Harry Potter. It's not Harry Houdini. I call him Harry because he's covered with
hair.
No, fur. He's covered with fur. That's right, fur. And he's waving at everybody. Now, Harry, you know, this is what we have for my wife's birthday. My wife, Lynn, is having a birthday tomorrow, and we're going to give her a nice red rose because she loves red roses. What are you doing? Harry, you've eaten up the rose. Put that thing back. Now, don't do that. That was not nice. Anyway, Harry, what are you doing? What? You're hungry. Put it back. Now, look, don't do that anymore. And if you see him start to do that, you let me know. Just let me know. Harry, what have you done? Stop. What? You swallowed it. He swallowed my wife's flower. I cannot believe it. What? You can put it back by magic? How you doing? Have all the boys and girls count to three. Watch what happens. One, two, three. Well, look, he did it. Give that rabbit a great big round of applause. What? You can do another magic trick? All right, I'll tell you what. I know what it is. Put the handkerchiefs. I knew that was coming. You want me to take the two handkerchiefs and let you hold them right there. And then I have this right here, but I don't need it yet. I need this handkerchief right here with all the different colors. Okay, Avalon, shake that handkerchief open. Shake it open. Shake it. Shake, shake, shake. Shake, shake, shake. Push it all the way down in the bottom. All the way down to the bottom like that. Now watch what Harry does. One, two, three. Avalon, reach in there and pull it out. Pull out the bottom. Pull it all. Look, it's gone. It's disappeared. Tell you what, you hold the yellow, I'll hold the blue. Let's count to three and we pull. One, two, three. Pull. Would you look at that? The handkerchief's back and the applause is deafening for Harry the Magic Rabbit. There he is. Look at that. Thank you. Now what? You brought something for Avalon. Oh, you brought a picnic lunch. What did you bring? Pizza, hot dogs, hamburgers, barbecue, chicken. Oh, man. And you got to go down and get them? Okay, go down to the basement and get them. He's going all the way down to the basement. Oh, you got him what? He said he's got them in his lunch box. Okay, tell you what. I want you. What? Oh, you're going to hand me the lunch box? Well, hand it to me. He's going to hand me the lunch box. Here we go. There's the lunchbox right there. I'll tell you what. I'll just put that over here out of the way. And what do you have for a drink? Oh, I see. You got what? He's got orange juice, apple juice, grape juice, juicy juice, and bug juice. Which one you want?
Orange juice.
Aren't you? He said he's out of orange juice. Sorry. You're out of grape juice, too. Out of apple juice. You're out of bug juice. What do you have? Snake juice. You want snake juice? I tell you, Harry, what are you doing? Wait a minute. Look at this. Harry, you were a puppet, and now you're a real live bunny rabbit. Would you look at that? There he is, Harry the real live rabbit. Let's give that rabbit a big round of applause. Look at that. And Avalon, you can rub him on the back so that he won't jump all that off that table. This is Harry the Rabbit with his white fur coat and his little bunny ears and red eyes. You know why? Because he drinks too much cherry Coke. Watch out, boys and girls. You don't want to wake up with red eyes in the morning. No, no, no. That's the story of the rabbit house, and the kids just love it.